Assalamu alaikum students and welcome to my channel Management Hub. In the previous video, we discussed about planning, formal planning, and why do managers plan. Continuing the chapter 8, in this video, we will learn the definition of goals and plans, types of goals and types of plans. That is, we would be covering objective number 2, that is classify the types of goals organization might have and the plans they use. Planning is referred as the primary management function, as the most important one, because it establishes the basis of all the other things managers do, as they organize, lead and control. It involves two important aspects, that is goals and plan. So let's see the definition of goals and plans. Goals, also known as objectives, are desired outcomes or targets that the company wants to achieve. They guide management decisions and are often described as essential elements of planning. You have to know what is your desired target or outcome before you establish plans for reaching it. On the other hand, plans are a kind of document that outline how goals are going to be met. The documents usually include resource allocation, schedules, and other necessary action or other things to accomplish the desired goal. For example, if I have been assigned a task to deliver a lecture to my class via Zoom application from my director. So my goal would be to complete my task or the assignment in the given time period, and I will make a plan to achieve it, either by prioritizing the task among other work that I have to do, or by checking if I have the resources to complete it successfully, such as laptop, application itself, and maybe a headset. So these would be the resources that I would be needing to complete my task successfully. Moving on, types of goals. We can classify company's goal as either being strategic or financial. Financial goals are related to the financial performance of the organization, while strategic goals are related to all the other areas of an organization. For example, the financial goal of an organization would be to increase its profit margin by 20% in the next 12 months, whereas the overall goal of the company would be to just increase the overall revenue of the company, or maybe to improve employee skills by conducting a particular training program for them. The other two types of goals are stated goals and real goals. Stated goals are official statements of what an organization says about it and what it wants its stakeholders to believe in. As we discussed in the previous chapter, stakeholders are any constituencies in the organization's environment, maybe internal or maybe external, affected by an organization's decision and actions. These groups are significantly influenced by what the organization does. Stakeholders may include employees of the company, suppliers of the company, competitors, shareholders, its customers, and so on. Stated goals can be found in organization's charter, annual report, public relation announcement, or in public statements made by the managers of the organization. However, these statements are often vague or ambiguous and probably better represent management's public image rather than what the organization is actually trying to accomplish. On the other hand, if you want to know an organization's real goal, these goals and those goals that an organization actually pursue, we need to observe what organizational members are actually doing if we need to know the organization real goals. For example, a company may publicly commit to increase participation of its employees in key management decisions, while actually they are practicing a hierarchical top-bottom approach, that is top managers are making decisions while the middle managers and the lower level managers are obediently carrying it out and executing it. Now let's discuss types of plans. Firstly, we will discuss types of plans with respect to breadth. Strategic plans. Strategic plans that apply to the entire organization, they are the overall organizational plans. For instance, increase revenue and reputation with a new product line. For instance, a company has introduced a new product line in the market, so they want to increase revenue with the help of it. On the other hand, operational plans covers a particular operation area or a functional area of the organization. Maybe marketing department, finance department, human resource department, supply chain department, or a manufacturing department, and so on. For instance, a hotel may improve housekeeping services such as quality control inspection to ensure rooms are spotlessly clean. So here they are focusing on the housekeeping department. That would be a particular operational area of the organization. But if a hotel says to increase revenue or maybe to increase reputation of the hotel in the eyes of customers, so that would be a strategic plan because it covers the entire organization. Then types of plans with respect to time frame. There are two types of plan with respect to time frame. Number one is long-term plans. A plan with a time frame beyond 3 years. For example, if you say you need to graduate from a university. So a graduation needs almost 4 years to complete. So this would be a long-term plan. Whereas a short-term plan would be a plan covering 1 year or less than a 1 year. For example, to take a class, that would be a 3 hour plan. Finish an assignment, maybe the deadline would be for a week or so. Or pass a semester would be for 4 months or 5 months. So that would be a short-term plan because it will be finished within a year or maybe a less than a year. Then there are two types of plan with respect to specificity. Specific plans are clearly defined and they leave no room for interpretation. For example, if a student say that I'll revise all the chapters in a week time or get B plus or more in all the subjects enrolled in this semester. So it is a specific plan which leaves no room for interpretation. A student is saying that he or she will revise all the chapters in a week time. Whereas directional plans are flexible and set out journal guidelines. So for the organizations that are innovative or that are that have a huge impact because of their external environment, maybe using directional plans. For example, if a student say to revise a chapter, to revise all the chapters or to pass the semester with flying colors. So the student is not mentioning the time frame here. And in the other example, it's he just want to pass the semester and it's not mentioning with what grades or with what GPA. He just wants to pass the semester with good grade or good marks. Then there are two types of plan with respect to frequency of use. Number one is single use plan. A single use plan is a one-time plan specifically designed to meet the needs of a unique situation. For example, if an advertising campaign for a new product launch, for instance, if Coca-Cola is making a advertisement for Maaza Mango. So they need to come up with a new advertising campaign. Their old campaign for Coca-Cola would not be working for this particular brand. So it is a unique situation that they have to launch a product. So they have to come up with a new advertising campaign. On the other hand, Standing plans are ongoing plans that provide guidance for activities performed repeatedly. Those things that are performed on a routine basis, so we have standing plans for that. It includes policies, rules, and procedures. For example, a social media policy is developed by ICRA University. It provides guidance to students while mentioning the university name on any social media platform. So if any student uses the university name, a social media policy has been already made and it will be automatically applied to each and every student enrolled in the university. So this is the end of this video, and we will continue this chapter in the next video. Thank you for watching.